Joao Andrade and Peter Hollands from WideCells are both with me on Skype this morning. Good morning to you both. Good to have you with us.
Good morning.
Joao, if I can kick off with you. News here this morning, WideCells has been granted a government-backed Innovate UK KTP here with Manchester Metropolitan University. A significant partnership, Joao. Tell us a bit more.
Yes, yeah, so we have been involved with stem cell research for almost 8-9 months now, mainly contract research projects. And it's great news for us to have been granted this knowledge transfer partnership funded by Innovate UK. The project that we are now involved is completely in line with our mission to make stem cell treatments accessible globally. And Peter is going to explain in more detail what the project is all about.
Yeah, please, Peter, if we can bring you in at this point, give us some more detail on what this research involves.
Yeah, so very exciting stuff. We've managed to get some funding from Innovate UK, which is a government organisation, and the funds will be used to provide, first of all, to provide funds to employ a postdoc scientist, and this person will actually drive the project on a day-to-day basis, and also funds to cover all the materials and consumables and equipment that's needed for the project. And this is over a 3-year period, so very exciting stuff. But the work itself is with Manchester Metropolitan University. A good friend of mine called Professor Tristan McKay runs the stem cell lab there. And what we're going to do is we're going to be working on a subject called induced pluripotent stem cells. Now, that's a bit of a mouthful, so let's call them iPSCs for now. And what iPSCs are is that they, what you can do, if you take a normal cell from a person, say some skin or some blood or something, you can actually introduce new genes into that cell. And as a result of doing that, you get a stem cell. And this stem cell can then be used to treat people or study disease and so on. So the purpose of this particular project is to develop clinical grade iPSCs. And this is really important because at the moment, this technology really just sits in research labs and doesn't get very much further. And the reason for that is that they're not produced to clinical grade. And what we will be doing, we'll be developing the technology from MMU and using our procedures and quality management and clinical grade experience, bringing those two together in a true partnership to develop what will be a completely novel product in the stem cell world. And that'll be clinical grade iPSC, so very exciting.
Is there quite a big market for this?
Potentially enormous. I mean, it fits in with the uses of the cells. So, for example, iPSCs could be used to treat disease. So they could be used in cell therapy for the regenerative medicine procedures. And they can use it to be used to study disease. These cells are very clever. They can form little pieces of tissue in the laboratory. So, for example, you can drive them to make little pieces of brain or little pieces of liver or kidney or whatever. And these are called organoids, and you can study these in the laboratory. And perhaps most importantly, they can be used to test pharmaceuticals. So if you imagine a patient with a disease and you don't know which drug to give to them, you could take some cells, make iPSCs, and then test the drug on the iPSCs. And we're then in the realms of personalized medicine, where instead of patients just receiving whatever drug is on the shelf, they actually receive the drug that's very specific to them, that has the very best benefit to them. So the potential's enormous on this particular technology.
Sounds like quite a hot topic. Are many others looking into this?
There's quite a few others, but like I say, most of them are research lab based. I mean, our colleagues at MMU are a research lab, so they've done fantastic work and they developed the technology, but we now need this next step to bring it to clinical grade, and that's what we're going to do.
So it sounds like they're a good team to be partnering up with.
Yeah, fantastic. Yeah. It's a very, very good and innovative and forward-thinking team. And Tristan McKay, who leads the group is great.
I suppose it wouldn't hurt just to have a quick reminder here, Peter, about Innovate UK. Tell us a bit more about them.
Yeah. I mean, a very interesting organization, government-based, and they fund a wide range of biotech, so not just stem cells, but a whole wide range of things. And we've got this knowledge transfer partnership. And what this means is that they're actually providing money so that we can work together, we can collaborate, we can form a partnership. So MMU have all the know-how about making iPSCs. We have all the know-how about clinical grade work and quality management and procedures and so on. Bringing those two together makes a completely unique product, and Innovate UK are enabling that. I mean, the other day they awarded 33 of these particular research grants, and we were apparently number 5 on the quality list in that group. So exceptionally good for a first attempt. And very excited to get the work underway.
Certainly, Joe, if I can bring you back in at this point, tell us a bit more about how this quite exciting research here fits into the business.
Well, effectively, this knowledge transfer partnership will enable WideCells to become the first UK company to bring clinical-grade iPSCs to the general market at scale. And that's by developing a manufacturing and frozen banking facility in Manchester for clinical-grade iPSCs. Now, by incorporating clinical-grade iPSC technology into our service offering, it fits perfectly with our company's vision, as I mentioned at the start, to make stem cell treatment more affordable and accessible globally. So basically, WideCells will be able to enter a new global market offering clinical-grade products tailored to the client's needs.
Just remind us about the financials involved here in terms of who's sharing what costs.
So it's £214,000 grants in total, 70, and that's over a period of 3 years. And 77,000 is contributed by WideCells, and all the remainder is contributed by Innovate UK.
Well, very exciting indeed, Joe. So another step forward here.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's in all fronts. It's from the Wide Academy side, where we launched the platform with our research arm. Now with this Innovate UK project, we received the license from the Human Tissue Authority as well. And we started to offer stem cell banking services in the UK. And we are looking now into Europe. Cell planning is continuing to develop. So all divisions are now starting to generate revenue.
Joe, Peter, good to speak to you both. Thanks very much.
Thank you.